morning, CIS scholars. How are you all? Hope you all are great. In my last video, I have discussed the workbook exercises. Today, I am going to start the new chapter, that is the temperate and the frigid zone. So, let's begin the video. In this video, I am going to discuss temperate zone, climate of temperate zone, and the plant life at temperate zone. So, let's see the first slide, that is the temperate zone. So, what is temperate zone? The temperate zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer, that is 23.5 degree north, and the Arctic Circle, which is 66.5 degree north in the northern hemisphere. And the Tropic of Capricorn, which is 23.5 degree south, and Antarctic Circle, which is 66.5 degree south in the southern hemisphere. Look at this figure. Here you can find it out. Look at this. This is a temperate zone. It lies between 23.5 degree north and 66.5 degree north. So this is in the northern hemisphere. So this is north temperate zone. Similarly, when we move south, here we have temperate zone, which lies between the Tropic of Capricorn and between the Antarctic Circle. Now let's see what is the other things in temperate zone. The large portion in the temperate zone is covered with short and soft wild grass, which is called grasslands. So here in temperate zone, you will find very short grass, which is known as grasslands. The grasslands are usually found on plains, and there are almost no trees in this region. So there is only grass, whereas there is no trees. The grasslands are known by different names in different countries and continents. Like in North America, we say prairies. In Russia, we say steppes. In South America, we say pampas. In South Africa, we say velders. And in Australia, we used to call them the downs. So these are the different names of these grasslands in different continents and countries. They are mostly found in Argentina, parts of North America, South Africa, Russia, and in the Darling River basin of Australia. So these are the places where we found all these grasslands. Now look at this. These are some of the grasslands. When we talk about the prairies, it is in North America, pampas in South America, then steppes in Russia, and velders in South Africa. So look at the picture. Through that you will get an idea that how it looks like. Now the temperate grassland. Look at this picture. This is our map. It is given in your book. Here you can find the various grasslands. You can see that this is equator, and this is the temperate zone between Tropic of Cancer and between the Arctic Circle. This is the in the northern part we have prairies, and we have steppes, that is in Russia. Similarly, when we talk about the southern part, that the south temperate zone, here we have pampas. In Africa, South Africa, we have velders, and in Australia we have downs. So this is all given in your book. You can see in your textbook the same map is given. Now let's discuss the climate of the temperate zone. That what type of climate we have in this zone. The climate experience in the grassland in the northern and southern hemispheres varies greatly. The grassland in the northern hemisphere are located far away from the sea towards the interior of continents. So there is a difference of temperatures during the summer and winter seasons. So it means that in northern hemisphere, the grasslands are situated far away from the sea, that is in the interior of the continent or the country. The climate in the temperate zone is extremely hot during summer and quite cold in winter season. There is moderate rainfall during summer and heavy snowfall during the winter. So what type of temperature this zone has extremely hot during summer and quite cold in winter, and it has a moderate rainfall during summer and heavy snowfall during winter. The hot and dry winds called Chinook blow over the prairies. These winds cause a quick change in the temperature. So there is a hot and dry winds which keeps on going, that we call them Chinook, which blow over the prairies. Now let's see what type of plant we have in this temperate zone. The region received low or moderate rainfall, due to which tall trees would not grow. The temperate grasslands are generally treeless. Why they are treeless? Because of the low rainfall. Vegetation in the temperate zone varies greatly from one region to another. Ryegrass, then buffalo grass, then foxtail and the alfalfa are some common grasses which are found in these region. The grasses help to reduce erosion and conserve water. So these are some of the grasses which are mostly found in these temperate zone. Then the prairies have now been cleared for agriculture. So nowadays generally the prairies grassland is being cleared. Why we have cleared all these prairies grassland? Because of the agriculture purpose. And what type of crops generally farmers are growing there? They are growing wheat and corn. So crops such as wheat and corn are mainly grown by the farmers in these region. Now the common grasses which are found in these region are, look at the picture, this is foxtail, where you can find it out, you can see the picture, alfalfa, then we have buffalo grass and we have the ryegrass. So these are some of the common grasses which are found in these temperate zone. I hope that in this video you have a clear understanding about that what type of plant life and what type of climate we have in temperate zone. So in my next video I am going to discuss more about the same region. By the time you can read this chapter, especially page number 41 and 42, and you have to underline the hard words while reading. So whatever words you will feel that they are the difficult to remember, you can just underline that words with pencils. So take care of yourself, be safe at home, and enjoy the learning. Thank you.